So I've been playing around with MidJourney and I made this post recently where I blended two things together, a Santa Claus and a T-Rex, and I came up with this idea. So in this video, I want to show you how to use the blend mode in MidJourney, and I'm going to show you how to upscale a design within MidJourney. They just released a feature not too long ago where you can make things even bigger. So it's not 1024 by 24, you can 4x it in MidJourney. Let's go. Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I want to show you two things in MidJourney. The first feature is /blend, and I'm going to show you how to blend two things together. Results may vary, so I don't know how these are going to turn out. They may turn out really weird. They may turn out pretty good. I'm going to take the best one of these, and then at the end of this video, I'm going to show you how to upscale it within MidJourney. So you won't need to upscale it in any other app. You can do it within MidJourney. And I'm going to show you how big it is compared to 4,500 by 5,400. So let's go to MidJourney now and let's start blending things together. All right, so here we are on MidJourney. I did a few prompts and things here because we're going to mash up these. Now, you don't have to use MidJourney designs. You can use your own designs. Can use designs off the internet. I'm going to show you how to use these though. So I'm going to mash up a few of these together and we'll see what the results are. So the first one, let's do a sushi and a dragon. So I'm going to go here and click on here and we're just going to take a screenshot. So if you don't know how to do a screenshot, you just do Command Shift 4, yeah, and then on a Mac. And I don't know how you do it on a PC, sorry, but on a Mac you do it like this, boom, and then you can take a screenshot of that right there. And then I'm gonna do it on this one and then do Command Shift 4. Now you don't have to take a screenshot. You could upscale this one and then download it and then the PNG, and then you could use that as well. So you don't actually have to take a screenshot. I'm just doing a screenshot to save time and not to use some of my uploads or upscaling credits and things like that. So let's go here and I'm going to go all the way down and we're going to use the /blend mode. So slash, just like you would do /imagine, you do /blend. You can see it's right here. Blend images together seamlessly, and you have two, I think you can do up to five, right? And I'm just going to do two though. So I'm going to do blend. You can see I can bring them in here and I'm just going to take those designs that I save to my desktop here. And we're gonna see what happens when we blend these two together. I have no idea what it's gonna look like. Hopefully it turns out great. Even if it doesn't, I think it'll be very hilarious. So after you put those two in, I'm just gonna hit enter and it's gonna do its thing. Now it's gonna take a little while and it's gonna give me four results. So we'll see which one is the best one here. You could also, you don't have to blend, you could actually type in a prompt that says a dragon that looks like a sushi, but we'll see what this does here. I wonder if it even will have any sushi ideas. You can see, I can see some sushi in here. Let's see what happens. All right, so this is what happened with the dragon sushi mashup. Not bad. I don't see the sushi that much though. This one, I wish there was more sushi. I would say this one is the best one, but again, the dragon's great, but I don't see the sushi in here. Maybe, you know, maybe do it again or type in, maybe take this and then try and mash it up with the sushi again or whatever. But well, let's move on. Let's try another pair and see what happens. So I'm gonna try and do a cat and a samurai. So let's see. Of these cats, let's try this one. I think this one's really cute. I'm gonna do the screenshot again, boom, and then samurai. Let's see, I did a samurai here. Yep, let's see which one of these. I don't know, I think this one works pretty well. I love this, but I think all the things on the background might get crazy. So I'm gonna take this one. Now again, if you find a better samurai somewhere out with clip art or maybe on Canva or something, you can try it with those. But we're gonna do this. I'm gonna go all the way down, do my /blend. Blend, boom, and put these two together. Cat and Samurai. My hope is that it's going to have a samurai with the face of a cat and everything. I'm not sure if that's what's going to happen, but let's do it. Enter. Hey, this one came out pretty good. So these are the things. It understood the assignment. The ones that I like is this one. This one looks most like a sword, I think. Or this one right here. I could also hit it and try to do it again. Like if you didn't like this, you can also do this again, which, you know, repeat. And it will give you four other ones. But yeah, I like this one right here. The tail's kind of weird on this one. But the sword's really short on this one, but I think it kind of almost looks like a Jedi cat too. So pretty cool. I like how he did that. Okay, so let's do another one. We're gonna do a unicorn and an octopus. So I got a unicorn here. Geez, let's do this one right here. This will be fun. Take that one. And let's see, I did an octopus up here. Wow, I like this one right here. Let's do that. Okay, so we're gonna put those two together and see what happens. So I'm gonna grab it, put this here, and put this here. My hope is it's an octopus with the head of a unicorn, but you never know what's gonna happen here. So hitting return. Okay, wow, this is not what I expected, but it's pretty cool. So it gave the octopus hair, kind of like a Medusa. I took away the horn though, so it's like a horse that lives underwater with some hair. Pretty scary, some of these. This one's probably the cutest one. This is probably the scariest one. So not sure if anybody will want this on a t-shirt. We're gonna try another mashup. So let's do a dog and an doctor. Dogter. So here's a doctor. Let's see. I'm gonna take this guy right here, this bottom one. And a dog here. Let's see which one. Let's do, oh, this one has the most white. I think it will understand this one the best. Oh, by the way, I didn't show you my prompts, but they're very simple prompts. Vector art, colorful vector design with black outlines, a cartoon illustration of a dog sitting down on a white background. I'm doing the same thing with this. Vector art, colorful vector design, black out, cartoon illustration, pizza. The doctor of a Christmas tree and so on. So very easy prompts here in MidJourney too. So depends what you start with, I guess. You can do whatever you want. So blend again, I'll do dog, doctor, and enter. Yeah, so as I thought, it didn't do exactly, it did kind of give the face of a dog, but then you have also the feet of the dog or the body of the dog. So it is a dog, it is a dog doctor. This one has the stethoscope. I think this one's pretty cool, but having the four legs on the bottom seemed kind of weird. Wonder if it could cut it out. But yeah, it is a dog doctor. So mashup in a little different way than I thought. Okay, last one. Let's do Christmas tree with a pizza. I'm wondering if it's gonna do it. I actually wanted the pizza standing up straight, you know, like the shape, the triangle shape that way, but you know, let's see what happens. This one's pretty good. I should have said triangle piece standing up, a pyramid shaped pizza, I don't know. But we'll do it with this one and see what happens. So we got the pizza here, and then you got the Christmas tree here. Let's see if we do it. And we'll do blend this last one. This is the last one for this video. If you want others, let me know in the comments if you want me to try other stuff. But yeah, pizza, Christmas tree, and enter. So this one, I'm really surprised. It did do it. It did take the shape of the pizza, and it looks like a pizza and kind of a Christmas tree. I think out of all of them, I mean, at least it has a star up there. I wish it had some more Christmas lights. That would be really cool. Maybe I can add that later. But this one, I think, is the best one. So let's see which one would actually work on a t-shirt. What do you think? I think this one could slightly work on a t-shirt, maybe like Merry Christmas or Crustmas, some kind of Christmas pizza pun would be fun. I don't know if anybody would like a dog mixed with a doctor. That's not what I thought. This one actually looks really scary, and you can't really tell it's an octopus and a unicorn. It just looks like a weird horse. This one I think is one of the better ones. this one right here, or if I could make the, actually, if I save this as a vector, I could probably pull that out and make the sword a lot better. So I think that one probably is the strong one. And this one is a cool, very cool dragon. And maybe if it was on top of maybe ramen or something, but it doesn't look like a sushi. So, gosh, let's do the Christmas tree. I think since it's close to Christmas, this might be a fun one. I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna upscale number 2. So the way you do that is U 2, because it's 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm gonna do that first. And it's gonna take a little while, but when you upscale it, it's 1024 by 1024. But MidJourney just added something and it's called upscale 4 times. So you can upscale 2 times. 2 times 1024 by 1024 is 2048, right? 2048. If you upscale it 4 times, then it's 4096, 4096 by 4096, which is really close to 4500 by 4500. And really, unless you're gonna make this the full size, you don't need it 4500 because you're gonna add text and so on. So let's do that. Let's upscale it 4 times and I'll show you. It's gonna do it again because this one is 1024 by 1024 and this one will be 496 by 496. And then we're gonna bring it into Canva and I'll show you how big it is and we can upscale it and stuff. But in Canva, we're gonna be able to remove the background and add some text. So there you go, it's upscaled 496 by 496. I'm gonna go into my MidJourney app, which is this one right here. I'm gonna go to my images. You can see it's right here, the big one, big size, and I'm just gonna download it. So you can see right here, hit download. And you can see it's really big. Now, this isn't the best pizza Christmas tree that I've ever seen. You could probably type in, you know, in MidJourney, make me a pizza slice that looks like a Christmas tree and it probably would do it a lot better. But I'm gonna show you how to use this as a bigger size. All right, so here I am on Canva. I'm gonna just create a design, custom size, 4,500 by 5,400, boom. And then you can see tall rectangle. I'm gonna close this here. I'm gonna drag in the download that I did, boom. You can see it's almost the size, right? 4,500 by 5,400, you can see right there. And I can scale it up just a little bit. It doesn't matter, but it is a photo, so I can do edit photo. And one of the nice things I can do on here is I can erase the background. So background remover, it's gonna remove it for me. And then that way it'll be a transparent background and I can put text behind it or whatever I want behind it. And let's do that. So now you can see it, if I color the background, let's do this so you can see, yeah, it's totally knocked out, right? So now I can come in here with my design from MidJourney and I can type text here. Let's add a headline and I can do Merry. Let's do that up here. And I'm gonna do Christmas just for a pun. Now, this isn't the best font to use, so I'm gonna change it, and I'm gonna change this Mary to maybe some more Christmas-looking font. Not sure what that is, so we're gonna do, I don't know, maybe like a handwriting font. That would be cool. No, that's not a cool one. Actually, let's do just a capital. Christmas. That's kind of cool. Right. And let's do the same thing for this one. Mary, I kind of like just the, yeah, like that. Merry Christmas. And actually that could be on the bottom too. So we can move things around. Fun. Yeah, and if we want this on a black background, we could do that too. So let's see what it would look like on a black t-shirt. We would obviously have to change this to a white. Hey, not bad, right? Merry Christmas. That's pretty cool. Now, I would still work on this. Now, we could still add like snowflakes and stuff. Let's do that. Oh, I did snowflakes before. Let's do this. And we can color it white. Cool. Let's put some over here. We can rotate it. And maybe some down here. Cool. Anyway, whatever you want. It doesn't have to be exactly this, but I'm just showing you that it could work, right? Whoops. Merry Christmas. Boom, just filling in the space, right? Or you could use some other pizza pun or whatever. And then we can download this. Let's remove the background so that we, well, we don't have to remove the background here. We can remove the background when we download it. So download transparent background and PNG, and it's gonna be 4,500 by 5,400. I'll show you what it looks like. I'll bring it up here. Again, we can work more on this, but I just wanted to show you what it looks like. So here it is, transparent background. And you can see, like if we zoom in, it's not pixelated at all. It's still pretty big. And I think it'll work well on there. Of course, you could delete stuff here with like the magic eraser or magic edit thing. And you could do some other things in Canva, but not bad, right? Not bad right there. And the size is big enough now, especially if you're not gonna use the full size of it. 4,096 is close enough to 4,500 that you can scale it up a little bit without much loss in it or pixelating. But if you scaled up 1024 by 1024 and scaled it up, you're gonna see a lot of pixelation. So there you go, pretty cool. Mashing up with Blend and also upscaling in MidJourney. So there you go, your MidJourney tutorial. MidJourney can do a lot of things, but that blend mode is really fun. I think you can blend a lot of different things, come up with some really crazy stuff. Now, not all of them are gonna be great for t-shirts, but I think it's just a fun way to take two things together and kind of mash it up and see what the AI comes up with. Sometimes they're hits, like that cat, the samurai cat, looked just like what I thought it would be. But the dog doctor did not. So have fun with this. Let me know if there's other things you wanna see mashup. I could do this one again and test out the blend mode, maybe even with some shorts. I think it'd be fun too. Thanks so much for watching. And if you wanna see more MidJourney stuff as well as other AI stuff, I have the AI playlist right here. AI keeps changing and gets better and better, but here are some tutorials for you to try out and see what it can do so far. So thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.